Okay, we're overweight on the trainer. And I already slid it back to California legal. Even if I slide it back one hole past California legal, or two holes past California legal, it still won't work. It's still too heavy. So, we have to go back and have them take off a stack or two. And I come back here and reweigh. So I hope just to weigh it once. So we're by plane rides. We're heading back to direct marketing. Need to have them fix it. So we're about 34,000 pounds on the trailer axles together as a tandem, 34,000 pounds on the drive axles as a tandem, and 12,000 on the steer axle as a single. And that's 80,000. So we're at 12,180, which is not a problem. We're allowed 12,500 as long as our drives are at 33,500 or less. And we're at 29,660 pounds on our drives and 35,300 on the trailer for a total of 77,140. And we're only allowed 34,000 on the trailer, so yeah. I don't know how heavy these stacks of stuff is in the back, but we're gonna have to pull off one complete stack and put it on their scale that they have inside and see how much it weighs. And they're going to have to put that in our other capital trailer going to the same place, which will leave tomorrow. So I need the center lane. The right-hand lane up ahead goes on Interstate 84 all the way to I-5, and I don't need that. I need the center lane, which turns into 205 South. But there's a Y up ahead, and this lane splies off from 205 north, which I need. And we're on Interstate 84 west. Since since I did that, if I go to Denver or Salt Lake or someplace that's higher altitude and reload the trailer using the same trailer and everything, then go run across the scale, my scale's going to be off because it uses air to calculate weight. And since at different altitudes, the air in your airbags has a different density, so your weights are affected. So when I scaled this, it said that my trailer was at 31,500, 800, somewhere in here. When I crossed the scale, which has oil inside the scale, things holding up the scale, the sensors, it said I had 29,600. I'm 1,000 pounds heavy by calibration because the density of the air here is thicker than the density of the air when I last time I calibrated my scale on the last CAT scale. So now let's say I go to Sacramento and offload, reload there, and head right back up. I can pretty much verify that that scale is going to be approximately the same weight because the density of here for altitude change to the density of Sacramento is just a couple hundred feet, maybe 100 feet at most. But when you put a mile distance between the two places, yeah, it's definitely going to change the weights. Because I can feel it in the truck too. The higher altitude that you're at, the road, the ride is smoother. The less density inside the airbags are, the truck kind of floats a little smoother. It feels nice. Then you come down to here, the airbags are a lot harder because the density of the air is thicker. So that's the reason why you, when you go higher up in altitude, like in a jet plane or whatever, the cabin is pressurized to a density that your body can use. Because if you don't, suffocate. Same thing in the airbags. Different densities and different altitudes will change your weight. And CAT scale, I don't know if they know of this or not, but I know of this. So that's something you need to learn. Especially when you have an air gauge in your truck. You know, I have two weight gauges in my truck. One's a digital gauge, it goes from 0 to 100 psi. And the other one is analog gauge, it goes from 0 to 100 psi. And the other one's a digital gauge that converts pressure into pounds of weight. just in time for the train. Or no, light rail. Still train.
We're here.